instrument suite carried on the Curiosity rover isn't in and of itself a life detection experiment. But what the Curiosity rover is equipped to do is to look for evidence of ancient environments that could have hosted life, habitable environments. The ChemCam instrument functions by firing off a laser at a rock, and then from afar you measure the emitted plasma coming off the rock to tell the elemental composition, what the rocks are made out of. And so you shoot one rock, then you shoot another, you see how they're different, you compare them to standards that you shot on Earth, and you can get the composition of these rocks to plus or minus 10 or 15% or so, and in a relative sense, much more precisely in terms of roving around and being able to say, this geologic unit is different from this one. And that's where the huge benefit of ChemCam lies. Now, because that laser spot is so small, we focus on the laser, but there's also a very high-resolution camera called the RMI. So this camera takes microscopic images that allow you to find that point that you've shot and also look at it in the context of what's around it and the morphology of the rock units.
To understand Mars is to understand the geology, and so the rover is an automated geologist. And so we'll find things that we want to look at with these cameras. And then we go to this camera up here. This is a ChemCam. It's actually two instruments in one. It's a laser spectrograph, and it's also a microimager. There's a little telescope in here that it uses to do that with. The microimager can detect a human hair at 27 feet.
Another benefit of ChemCam is that you're able to do all of this remotely without touching the rock. So ChemCam is one of the essential tools for reconnaissance that the rover has to tell us where is it worthwhile to go and take a sample. Or if this is the same as this, maybe we should ignore it, drive on, find another rock. If it's sufficiently interesting, then you make the investment to spend up to a week's time at that site doing the process of drilling into that outcrop, acquiring a sample, sieving that sample, taking it into the body of the Curiosity rover where it can be analyzed by the ChemMin instrument for mineralogy and chemistry and by the SAM instrument for gas chromatograph, mass spectroscopy, and potential organics detection. So it's this process of triaging and trying to figure out where you spend your limited time and your limited resources. Well, I think some of the most exciting discoveries that could come out of the Curiosity rover's explorations are, first of all, the discovery of organic material. The other is the ability to measure the gases in the atmosphere of Mars, in particular this methane, which is potentially related to life. There's been a lot of controversy about whether methane exists or not, and I think the measurements that are going to come out of Curiosity might point one way or another to that. I would be really excited to see in situ evidence of either a lake or a hydrothermal system that formed some of these minerals that we see from orbit, clays and sulfates. It's been a big mystery over the past 7 years since these were first discovered. How the heck did they form? And I think with the Curiosity rover and its payload, we have the ability to answer that question, and that tells us a lot about what the environments on ancient Mars were like.